Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, dead, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hit. He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone. I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet. Something important waiting for me there. The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
recognize me, do you, Ryder?
You think you're God? You think you can just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and kill them when you think it adds to the drama? You're in this story now, and I'll make you suffer.
You sheep. You would be a multiple sentence in your books if it wasn't for your
editor.
You'll never publish another one of
your shitty stories.
Cause I'm gonna kill you.
It's not like your stories are any
good.
Not like they have any
artistic merit.
You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills
and pretentious shit.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me.
Look at your work.
That the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own
creation?
No way out.
Beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light. Darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The Hitchhiker has been taken over by the Dark Presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Now you'll die.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Baby, just another night. You dozed off.
Right.
Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here. Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife, if you don't mind me saying. I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize famous writers such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I can get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it just between us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller! How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry. We're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
Damn yuppies.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Try the coffee.
Do me a favor! Use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah. You need to give it a good solid whack. Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am. I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did. Hello? Mr. Stucky?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must remind someone.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah, splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Tom. Good to see you.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on you, would you, Tom?
I wish.
The Andersons, they're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home, okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Bad man here on KBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight. Alice had a phobia.
The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset. The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again. An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
A bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here. Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
Alice? Honey?
The old door had played a trick on me. Alice wouldn't have come out in the dark.
Just ran into one on the ferry. A famous artist, no less, but we'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now, let's go to the phones, caller. You're on KBS FM.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
Why, hello, Rose. What's on your mind?
I know who that famous artist was.
The water was black. I couldn't help but imagine all sorts of horrors lurking in the depths below.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn it, Alice! You... Everyone keeps...
Hey! Just hear me out! There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that! That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice! God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through. Damn it. Alice?
Alice!
Alice, no!
cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Alan! Where are you? Help!
Alice, I'm coming! It's all right! Coming!
No!
What
Alan!
The hell?
Oh, no!
Keep going, Alice. Wake up!
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot. Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either. The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Hello? Hello? Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night. The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake. Departure. The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Anybody there? Please! I've been in an accident!
Hey! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident! I need help!
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl,
ducky.
Pleased
to meet you.
Non-refundable reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
During your
stay on
trying
walking,
it's the latest.
Yes.
In
rightful.
Hello? Hello?
Despair. Fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station. Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now, she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief
was that?
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water. Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking. Taken. The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way. There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site. I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know, if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather's absolute. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and on nights like this, I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and it would keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Oh, Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but he's just for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks, Pat.
You have a good night now.
Thank you.
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act had reworld. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice. The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Who makes the best dogs in the state? Belly Burster is the best with no coat. Monster Dog is second best. The famous dog is...
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.